Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in Revit 2018 Imperial. If you did the previous exercise, go and open the file 00_007_DIAD where you save it, or go and download this file to follow along, or you can just sit down and watch. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save as icon. This will bring the save drawing as dialog box. Save this file to 00_0078_DIAB and click the save button. Now type tool. And use the down arrow key to select tool palette. Press enter. Move the tool palette out of the way and look for the architectural tab. Click the architectural tab. Now select the imperial door and place it to the window, and the imperial window, place it to the window. Imperial toilet. Close the tool palette. Now select this window and move it to the windows layer, 2D windows layer. Press escape. Select the door. Move it to the 2D door layer. Escape. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the layer properties. This will bring the layer properties manager. Click the new button. Create a new layer, plumbing. And change its color to something. Let's use the index color number 5, which is the cyan color. Change its line width to 0.025. Click OK. Close the layer properties manager. Now select this toilet and move it to the plumbing layer. As you can see, this is the front view of the toilet. But we need the floor, not the front. We need the floor plan, not the front. But because this is a dynamic block, AutoCAD give us so many options to based on how the block was created. When you look at this window, you see the word front in brackets. This time we don't need the front, we need the plan. So select the plan, the block change automatically. Use the move tool and move this toilet into this location. The placement isn't important at this moment, just to indicate that this is a toilet. Now select the window and hover your mouse cursor into this area. If you click, you see so many options. You can expand this window up to 5. Press escape to get out of the command. Now use the copy command and copy this window from this point to this point. Press escape. Select this window, use the mirror command and mirror this window to the opposite direction. Select the both windows. Copy them into a new location, use this as a base point, copy it here, and if your auto mode is on, turn it off. Press escape to get out of the command. Now let's change the width of the window by clicking this arrow and change it into 6. Select this window. Change the width to 6 inches. Press escape. Now select it and copy it into a new location. Paste it here. Paste it here. Press escape. Select this window. Use the mirror command. Click this point and move down. Turn on the auto mode and click. Press enter to accept the default option. Select the two windows. Use the copy command and copy them into a new location. Press escape. Use the move command and move this object. Select the window and use the rotate command. Use this as a base point and rotate it up. Select this window and use the mirror command. Mirror this window to the opposite direction. Press enter. Select these two windows. Use the copy command. Copy this window from this point to this point. Press escape. Select this window again. Copy it down. Use this midpoint as the base point. Move down and paste it into this area. Press escape. As you can see, the window is bigger than the opening. Now, since the window is a dynamic block, that will not going to be a problem. Select the window and adjust the size to 2 feet 6. Now move it down to the right location. Select this door and copy it into this area. Press escape to get out of the command. Select the door again and reduce the size to 3 feet. Press escape. Copy this door into this area. Press escape and select the door. Go to the home tab, modify panel, select the rotate command. Use this point as a base point. Click here and move the mouse cursor into this direction to the left part and click. Again, the door is bigger than the opening. Select the door and move it into 3 feet. Press escape. Select this door again and copy it into this location. Click here, escape. Select this door, click this grid and change it into, change the distance to 4 feet, 3 feet. Now flip the door and use the move command. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the move command. At the prompt specifying base point or displacement prompt, click this as a base point. At the specifying second point or use first point as a displacement prompt, click this point. The door is now in the right location. Select this door again and use the copy command. At the prompt specifying base point, click at this point, then paste this door here. Press escape. Now select the door and click this flip arrow. The door flip into the right orientation. Now click this grip and move it to the right distance, which is 3 feet. Now select the copy command. At the specified base point prompt, click here, and at the specified second point or click here. Press escape. Now use the rotate command. Select the door and go to the home tab, modify panel and select the rotate command. Use this as a base point and move to the top direction and click. Select the door and move it down. Press escape to get out of the command. Select the window and go to the home tab, modify panel and select the copy command. At the specified base point prompt, use the endpoint object snap and click here. Now copy this window and use this endpoint at the second point. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select the window and use this clip to reduce its size to 2 feet 6 inches. Press escape to get out of the command. Select this door and go to the home tab, modify panel and select the copy command. At the prompt specifying base point or displacement mode, use the endpoint object snap and use this point as a base point. At the prompt specifying second point, click into this area to place the door. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select the door and click the flip arrow. The door flip into the right orientation. Again, I don't want the door, this door to open in this angle. I want it to open and lap in this area. So click this flip arrow will flip the door into the right direction. Press escape to get out of the command. Again, this area here is going to be a slider, so I'm going to grade this slider manually instead of taking it from the library. Now I'm going to zoom in into this area, then go to the home tab, modify panel and select the make current layer command. Select the door. The 3D door layer is now the current layer. Select this line and use the midpoint object snap click. Move the line into the opposite direction and click. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 1 inch and press enter. Select this line, offset it up. Select this line and offset it down. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command again. For the offset distance, enter 3 inches on your keyboard. Offset this line and offset this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the rectangle command. Draw a rectangle from this point to this point. Press enter to repeat the rectangle command again. Draw a rectangle from this point to this point. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. For the offset distance, enter 0.25. Press enter. Offset this line down and offset this line up. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 3 inches and press enter. Offset this line into this direction and offset this line into this direction. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the rectangle command. Click here to start your rectangle and move into this direction. Zoom in to see clearly and click. Select the rectangle command again and draw another rectangle at the bottom. Press enter. Now select these two lines and these two lines and erase them. Select this line, and erase them. Select this rectangle, go to the home tab, modify panel and select the mirror command. Use at the prompt specifying first mirror line, use the midpoint object snap and click. Move your mouse cursor either at the bottom or at the top and click. At the erase source object prompt, select yes. We don't want to retain the source object. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the line command. Use the midpoint object snap and start a midpoint from the midpoint of this line. Move up and click. Press escape to get out of the command. Start the line command again and use the midpoint object snap and snap at the midpoint, at this midpoint. Move the line until you see the perpendicular object snap. Click. Press enter to end the line command. Select this rectangle and use the mirror command. At the specified first point of mirror line prompts, use the midpoint object snap and click here. Now move your mouse cursor down and click. Press enter to accept the default option. Now go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 0.125, press enter. Offset this line up and down. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this rectangle and go to the home tab, modify panel and select the move command. Use the midpoint of this line and click, then move this rectangle into this area. Select this midline and erase it and go to the home tab, modify panel and select the trim command. Press enter. Trim off this object. Press escape. Now select this line and erase it. Select all these objects and erase them. Select this object, use the mirror command. Go to the Home tab, modify panel, and select the mirror command. At the prompt, specify first point of mirror line. Click at this end point and move the mouse cursor down and click. Press enter to accept the default option. Now select this line and go to the Home tab, modify panel, select the mirror command. Click this end point and this end point. Select the yes option. Select this rectangle. Go to the Home tab, modify panel, and select the mirror command. Click this endpoint and this endpoint and accept the default no option. Now erase this line. Our slider is complete. Go to the quick access, go to the navigation bar and select the zoom window button. If the zoom window is not the current, click this down arrow and select the zoom window. Then specify a window in your drawing area to zoom to the extent of that window. Click the save button. Alright, in this tutorial, we learn how to invoke the tool palette, how to take objects from the tool, how to take a dynamic block from the tool palette, how to use the capability of the dynamic block to adjust a block, to flip it and orient it in the right direction. In the next tutorial, we're going to learn how to take objects from the design center to place more symbols in our drawing. If you find this tutorial very useful, please click the share button and share it to your friends. If you have any comment or question, or you want a specific tutorial, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue on this series, please subscribe for more tutorials. Thank you very much for watching. Goodbye.